Fala galera, beleza? Sejam bem-vindos a mais um vídeo. E no vídeo de hoje é os highlights, são os melhores momentos das partidas profissionais de CS. Caso você curte esse quadro aqui no canal, não se esquece, se inscreve aqui no canal, sua inscrição é muito importante para a evolução do mesmo aqui na plataforma. Seu like mostra pro YouTube que você curte demais esse estilo de conteúdo, fechou? Deixa de enrolação e vamos pro que importa, são os melhores momentos. Bora lá.
The T's threw their own smoke there and now they want to go through it. Molotov under the porch. No shots really connecting though, as everyone's kind of whiffing. Snow does eventually find one through the smoke and QZ tucks himself away in the back of the site. Big Uzera and him are here. The whole team has rolled up. And oh, wait a minute. Oi. Wait a minute, Vinny. Okay, three headshots.
Gonna push his wave forward. Has got that defuse kit, so will be the one that you don't want to be seeing dropping. Luckily, he's got that duel against Vinny on lock, who was low on HP anyway, and so plenty of time for the defuse regardless. It was a good attempt. It was a nice attempt from Vinny, but just a bit too much asked of him, and PaiN will...
He has to wait for the full commit. Right now, there's the nades going. Oh, he does just a little bit too early. Doesn't land his shot. What he has done is allow his team to stack up the bomb site, and for some reason, they're all behind the smokes. They didn't push into the site when they knew that the play was towards B. They had the flank. All of these CTs should have been inside of this site, ready to shut this down. Instead, now it's a 4v4 retake. NQZ does get one, so that's a good start for them. But they've been resmoked off in CT again.
Yeah, well, I guess you're gonna have to make do. NQZ creeping his way forward, should be losing his life to Phelps. Where's the trade to come through? Not from Snow. And Cowers is cowering. Although he will eventually get that trade back. Time is actually starting to get the better of PaiN. I can't believe they've lost that round.
They have nothing to stop this. Molotov misses though. And that's crucial because that would have Molotov'd him out of his position. And now Kalez wins the fight. Oh, it's getting bad. It's getting bad and everything's fine. My bad. I'm the one who's bad.
Would have won that previous round. They'd be up 3-0. Imperial would have been in a bit of a spot economically. But if this rap is going to come in around the world, which might seem to be the strategy from Imperial immediately, and Snow's good for one, somehow two, and Big Uzera's rotated across to help out as well. That is unreasonable. 10 seconds left here for Descenti. There's just no chance he's going to be able to win the round.
That is completely outrageous. From
flashes, and here comes Imperial straight out onto A. Not too successful with their entry this time around. They just try that carpet's pop and luxury of being able to go to B because the bomb's been dropped. Are finding some kills. There's one. Phelps will look for another. Cowers changing up his position in pit. It's going to be imperative. He won't be able to survive though, as Phelps is going to knock him over with the assistance of Vinny. And that is the bomb plant. PaiN getting themselves into all sorts of sticky situations. The util tossed out. Good counter util out from Imperial, but still the frags going the way of the T side for a start. All because Sarah
Mirage and Inferno themselves have been played more than all of the rest of the map pool combined in competitive play.
Yep. How about this? Look at this round. This round is going to be fun. That's fun. We like that. Oh, but actually, Imperial kind of come away with that one not too badly, all things considered. Cowers won't be... Neither player having been able to get off of the side. He's going to potentially make for a pretty difficult post plan, especially now with Phelps being tagged down and now finished off. Try. We'll have to do something nifty-esque, and that's just not...
Está cansado de abrir seu CS e jogar sem nenhum skin, né? É caro, eu sei. Mas muita calma nessa hora, meu amigo. Eu vou te ajudar. Esqueça de abrir caixas na Valve e abre agora mesmo a sua primeira caixa no CSGO Fest. De graça, utilizando meu link abaixo. Site justo e mais antigo no mercado de skins. Um lugar perfeito para conseguir sua nova skin. Abre suas caixas e troca até aquelas skins que você não curte mais no seu inventário. Lembrando que é apenas para maiores de 18 anos. E faça tudo com bastante responsabilidade. E aí, curtiu de verdade? Então utilize meu cupom aleArts e além de ajudar o canal, você ainda ganha 10% de bônus no seu depósito.
The flashes come through, but did they see Snow tucked away at the car? They didn't. He's only good for one. Quick trade from Phelps. Big Uzera is here, but he's stuck behind a smoke. As nades come in, that's going to open it up. And we see him get one.
Oh, the big old rap. Oh dear, that's not gone well, but still, Vinny's here. Vinny's alive, and Vinny's the one that's cracking heads at the moment. So it'll be okay. Imperial will just... Because if Imperial pick it up and he steam away with a couple of rounds quickly here. In fun, no. Because it's no fun. Anyway, Tri's also having no fun there with the USP fight against the P250. It's...
Yeah, I really think on Inferno, it actually probably is worth it to have four guys with dualies and just scrap the USPs entirely, except for fights like that, where Vinny, thanks to the tactical whiff from Descenti in the previous half, oh, he's still going. He's got the defuse as well. And oh my God, Vinny has done it again.
Well, Vinny is going to do the exact opposite. No one even shot back.
How does he keep managing to find the perfect timings in everything he does? Vinny has just been flawless today.
Instead, No Way has actually committed to the sight hold this time. So he's going to live by the sword, die by the sword. And so far, he's living well. It is going to be some assistance coming through from his teammates as well that ends up resulting in a favorable exchange for Imperial. But a bomb plant still, nonetheless, for PaiN.
And re-smoke out towards CT. So that's going to make things difficult. Descenti, again, is so late on his rotation. They're constantly worried about these lurkers, but Phelps finds the timing on Big Uzera, trying to sneak across. Now, they know that Kawez was towards the site, but they don't know if he's moved back. They have the kits, so time starting to tick away, but not much of an issue yet. Kawez is going to have to find some massive shots. There's the first one. They know he's tucked away now. There's the second. Try has to land this one, and does, just in the nick of time. He's got plenty.
He would have spammed through that smoke, probably cleans up one or two even potentially, but decides to hold his trigger finger. This ends up being a little bit more messy, but Try for the double from Pit might have just saved the round. No Way gets himself in all sorts of trouble. He has stopped Big Uzera from getting off of the site. That's the one big advantage that Try has, though the shot's not going to be hit. One on Pit and one on Balcony, fair, whatever, but... I don't really like their chances. This is going to have to be a very clean entry, and it's not. Not unfortunately, if you're a PaiN fan. Oh, going to get the bomb plant down, which is something. But a 3-on-2 post plant. Imperial are still favored here with how low HP those remaining PaiN members are.
Well, and especially with that re-smoke out towards Moto, those smokes last forever now. It was one of the big updates from CSGO to CS2 was just... how long the smokes last. Try, get your gun out, son. Get your gun out. Lux is inside of the halls. And now they have a decent amount of information. They know that they're playing heavy towards halls and Pit. Not sure exactly where he is. No Way finds him. He's lit. He's really low, but someone has to get on the bomb. They don't have a kit. It's a round for PaiN.
Oh, no.
Somehow they've stolen this one away again. PaiN just cannot keep getting away with this.
I... for another step or two, but an equally placed one is going to force Descenti out from underneath porch. Ooh. Oh, and unfortunate for Descenti to go down there. The cowers, it was a good start for Imperial. They had the 4-on-5, but they didn't have it for very long.
Peeks right back into the spray through the smoke, and Phelps, he wants a couple of his own. They still have two players over towards B, and this is the problem with Inferno. You always have to gamble on these stacks, and when you get it wrong, it can cause problems. Will they expect Vinny here in the pit, though? That is the question. They know that there's probably one player nearby somewhere, but they just don't know where. And crucially, Imperial, they can't rotate over quickly because they don't know where PaiN is. Now they seem to have an idea. Two players making their way towards the site, and that's a whiff shot from Vinny. Snow gets the big one, 2-on-2, and...
and with NQZ, AWP on the site should be good for one. Is tags down, No Way. An impossible retake now for Try. There's just nothing he can do. Especially with the lack of funds available to Imperial, the best option is going to be to save here, but that is going to give another round over to PaiN. It will be the equalizing round as well. This has been a grindy, grindy half from PaiN, but they are starting to see the fruits of their labor in bloom.
Imperial's last full buy. If Imperial lose this one, then they're not going to be able to buy into the last round. That's a good way to start it. Just two kills where you don't even see a single opponent. That's what you like.
Yeah, and unfortunately for PaiN, just all that hard work sort of feels like it's undone. Unless they can bust their way back into A, that rotation that was coming across pretty damn quickly from Imperial. Helps in the cutout, all down to timing on his behalf. If he chooses to peek, he will, and he'll get the trade. It is a 2-for-1, so starting to maybe come back together here for PaiN if they can get that plant down, but both players sort of stuck in the pit here, and Phelps is looking threatening. We'll dislodge the pit player. But this is still winnable for PaiN. Snow, Big Uzera, Bigu can get himself one. Well, now it's not going to be enough. He would need to get three. Snow tried to force the issue a little bit, and that's just not going to happen. So 12th up for Imperial, and they now put themselves on match point, but it has taken them so long to get there. Oh, big round ahead here for Imperial. They could just still manage to snag away Inferno, and that's a great start for Tri, who's not really been having a huge amount of success in this second half, but that's a big round to start to come online. Vinny 21 and 13 is going to be tested now. Lux looking to go around the corner. We'll actually win that duel, though. No way is there for the trade. I know that he gets out. We'll jump back across. NQZ not sharp enough this time around. Imperium is somewhat committed to this B site. The flashes coming over the top, though, are going to push them back. Everyone was blind for a second there. Now No Way able to land himself the killing blow. And it's on to try to hit a timing shot through the smoke, which will not happen. In that meanwhile, Bushy's coming up the banana from the remaining Imperial members. They are going to be very fast and ready for this retake. In fact, they almost get ahead of it with Phelps peeking just as the bomb went down on the floor. And he's actually now found Snow as well. NQZ needs to come up in a big way. Try watching the angle. Wasn't able to hit the shot. And it's on to Decenti. One on two. He's hit the bink, but not the killing blow. It went through the wall. Big Uzera will swing alongside NQZ. And PaiN will secure OT.
I mean, he's just going to get caught. This should just be a double kill, I think. Yep, one and two for Kawes. They don't know where the third player is, and now he's found him. That's three. What a play. Sneaks right up mid and essentially wins the first round of the overtime for PaiN.
Positive signs early on in the piece for the OT. And you sort of...
I mean, it's a really nice angle to hold. It feels really good as an opper, but you want to be able to use that Molly. Now Phelps should be getting cleared. Does. Actually surprised Phelps didn't get that kill. That's usually a kill that you could count on him to get. But with only one player lurking, they pretty much have an inkling that this is going to be the B play. But what a flash. They send him right in. Try goes down. And now PaiN, they have the sight again. And another kill through the smoke. So one player very low. One player half. But still, how do Imperial retake this?
Just sailing away into nothingness. Kind of a metaphor maybe for the rest of the round here as well, because that's kind of the direction it's headed for Imperial as well. And maybe not just the round, maybe not just the nade, but perhaps the map as well.
Losing some rounds here. And PaiN, I mean, if they can go a clean 3-0, again, it's the opening for Imperial. Tri has actually got a lot of those. They just haven't been able to close them out. The mid rounds have been where PaiN have been most successful. As Snow walks around the corner right into Phelps's bullet. But I mean, this B bomb site, there's two defenders here, and this time they do hold on. Vinny in No Way with a kill apiece. NQZ, he was the hero in the last round of regulation, but this, I think, might just be too far for him. He throws the Lurk Smoke to sneak into CT spawn. Tri knows that that's probably his plan, so he backs up. He's waiting for it. No scope doesn't land, so Imperial flash.
Big hit from Imperial into the B side. It's only the one for one so far, but Lux is going to chance a timing out of the smoke, and he'll give up his life for his troubles. You've got two grenades here. NQZ and Kawas could put them to good use. This is actually retakeable for PaiN if they knew how much damage they'd done. If they even just chance their arm, NQZ here, toss a nade into Dark, especially. Spotted out No Way. It is going to be a bit of a fakey, though. It's the double pump. It's the double setup. Tries in that same corner. Might not be expecting that. Big Uzera will receive the flash forward, but raid doesn't quite go the way it needed to. There's a nade, though, from NQZ that should finish one more off. And he fuses on. Has he got it? He's got it. Smoke go down. It's not going to hold Imperial at bay this time around, but Big Uzera with the M4 might just do enough. He was helped out by NQZ, but not the right way. It's on to Kawes now to come up with the goods. The flash is going to go over the top of his head, but the player on balcony will shut him down, and that surely will be the round for Imperial.
Oh, he didn't hear Decenti, I think it was, running over top of him out onto the balcony. And, you know, they might just have a look. You know, not anymore, surely. Every time I try to say something like that happens. Now, what you might see here... where the bomb planted where it is. I was going to say, you might see Lux just toss that Molly into pit. Yeah, he's going to try it, but unfortunately for him, because of where it's planted, no one's saving over there anyways.
Dump a bit of util to try and make the job a bit more difficult for Imperial. NQZ is not moving a muscle, and that's a wise choice. He's going to get the kill under Vinny. In the meanwhile, though, Kawes has gone down. It's NQZ fighting hard alongside Bigu. but the trades are... And now he's going to be smoked
That's
off.
Huge.
But time, a really big factor here, and no way Try will make it happen. Imperial get themselves another crack at another overtime. And some of you two are getting crossed across now. That'll be info, spam through. And it's, yeah, a bit of an awkward one. Snow and Lux are able to combine for one. And now Snow has at least the second. Now, the question is, are they going to be expecting a third player on this B-bomb site? Then normally should only be the two. Powers is going to bide his time. And that's a little bit of a mishap from Imperial. They had plenty of time to clear the site and util to boot. And it has cost them, maybe not in a big way, actually, because Phelps... He's keeping it looking all right here. Descenti getting that bomb plant down. It's onto Phelps 1v1, but NQC. NQC again. Gonna be the difference maker here, potentially. Might not yet actually pay off, though. Imperial are gonna flash their way forward. Snow wants to try and take the fight. He hasn't even used the molly, but he's got the kill. Try is gonna push his way forward to try to contest, but Snow doing a great job of anchoring on this B bomb site, keeping himself alive, even finding the kill on the way through. He's got some util in check for the retake as well.
And that molly just trying to create a little bit of space for Try to get aggressive. He found one player. Oh, but he doesn't get the angle right. He thinks he has time to escape, but he doesn't. Snow peeks in, finds the frag, and this might be the first CT side lead that we see in these overtimes. It's now just no way. He has the op. They know exactly where he is, and NQZ is just too fast. We heard the tag for sure.
Ooh. Great start.
Vertigo even. Vertigo is going to be a big one, and that's another good start. The double kill for him to open up this round. And there's Snow. Yeah, I mean, this should just be no, Vinny. Surely not again. He's had some heroics in regulation. Now he's trying to have it in the overtime, but does eventually get put down. But not before he does a ton of damage to NQZ and Snow. And that nade, that HE that could potentially come in.
For number 19, they're going to throw a faster round in. Cowers on the entry duty. The shot's been missed by Try, and it's all starting to come together. That's nice. Very nice indeed from Cowers.
No, and NQZ's in a very funny spot. He should get one for free. Definitely not going to expect Phelps now. Well, he actually does. Whoa, Phelps lands the shot, though. Big Uzera closes it out. It is now all on Phelps. One versus four. And this one, especially with that Molotov in front of his face, I'd be tempted to throw my own molly under my feet at this point, I'll be honest with you. As he's looking, but they've got him completely crossfired. There's absolutely no chance. PaiN battling it out, battling back from the 11-6 lead that Imperial had. PaiN, bring it. And it is going to be the A play. They have the full util sets, two smokes, two mollies. And you can see Phelps, he does not want to wait for them to run up. He does not want them to choose the engagement. He's going to run straight back through the fire and somehow on 11 HP gets away. Try and no way get one apiece as well. And where is Cowes? Where is that lurk? There it is. One set of dualies down. It was the low HP player in Phelps. And the bomb actually, the bomb can make its way back over to B.
Oh, how is he not gonna expecting get another this? One. I don't know. That's a bit of a mishap from Try. What a great look as the new player into the team. There's going to be the player up through jump up. Vinny for the duel into CT spawn. Now it's on to Snow solo. So he's been spotted out already. This is actually quite a tough one to win. They should just flood him here. Two sets of dualies. They've both got HP. It's unwinnable, really, for Snow. Peel will get off.
I don't think he noticed him walking through the smoke. But Lux thought Phelps had seen him because really he should have. So he just runs forward, takes that kill, and then turns his back to the opponent.
Yeah, that was generous. Getting tossed on in, but Imperial just decided to go straight through that smoke and get in front of the fight. It looks all right until that extra trade starts to come through. Big Zera is last alive. And Try, well, he was waiting, ready to go.
Well, B-Exec should be on the way here. All the nades are rolling out. They've got mollies, they've got smokes, but what they don't have is weaponry to take down Descenti as he is tucked away here at the white box. Three kills, Vinny's there to help out, and NQZ essentially is just hoping to maybe get himself one kill. Stop
not
delaying!
Very likely. Out in front of the angles, though, yeah. Big Uzera has spotted it. A little bit of a elbow or knee or something poking around the girder there. enough to give PaiN their first round on the map. The smoke fades favorably for Lux. He'll drop to Vinny. But NQZ and Cowers should have this one on lockdown. They're both actually going to double up. Go on a bit of an expedition. Yeah, wrapping around behind Vinny. Not expecting that still. Maybe that's not quite. He's got some util that he can use to assist. He's got a smoke molly and a flash. But Vinny goes down for free. It would be a problem. Not the case, however. He's got a clean one on to Biguzera. And some of that counter util now coming into play for Imperial. It's keeping PaiN at bay. Smoke causing a couple of issues, but not really many in the end. And Imperial, Inferno, I thought they'd maybe just dropped off a little bit, but I suppose it is in line with what we'd seen in this event so far. A little bit up and down on that first day. And again, a little bit up and down here on semi-final as well. But currently doing enough to make it look like they're going to ease their way into what a map 3.
Sure does look that way.
This pick of Vertigo is blowing up in the face of PaiN Gaming at the moment. They are just not really doing anything. It's not looking like it's going to end up too kindly for PaiN. This is a tough one to break. They need to hit their shots cleanly, and they sort of do, but Phelps is shutting it down. He says, no, thank you very much. There was just one too many members there for PaiN to deal with. Try is going to be forced away from mid, but just hung around for some reason. And Gower says, thanks, I'll take that kill at least. There's definitely this like air of arrogance or confidence maybe from Imperial in some of these fights that they're taking. And
nothing else is working. We're losing 10 to 1. I'm just going to run at you. Like, that is what I'm just going to do now. As this time, he's waiting. And that's his third headshot of the round as he takes down No Way. There's one man still here, and that's Decenti at the back of the B site. Now, this would be a heroic round. Only able to get one. Almost with the second. Phelps on 13 HP. Just run and jump off the map. That's what I would do. Ah, he waited all that time for that!
the 13-2 nuke. You know?
It's a lot of rounds. That's a good start, though. Cowes, he started to heat up right at the end of that first half, and he's continuing to cook now. He's got those dualies in the side hall. Flash comes in. It's perfect as well. A trade from Vinny, but very low HP on two of the players. Try is going to have to do something immense here, and I'm not seeing a way in. Well, that, as I say it, gets the one headshot. The 3-on-3 still tries pushing forward for more, and this would be heartbreaking for PaiN. This would be absolutely heartbreaking to lose this one after how it started.
They might well lose it. Biguzera and Cowers are both quite low. Plant's going to be chanced here by Try. And PaiN have not pushed off the back of it. So that's their one chance for an advantage gone until it's just gone by the wayside. Easy as you like.
Yep.
It's the race from Imperial. They're making a bit of noise, though, on this ramp. And so Cowers, he wants to have a look. Phelps gives up his life.
Oh, it's happening.
It is. I'm starting to come around. It's early days, though. Don't get me too excited just yet. There's a good shot in from Try.
And he has all the util.
Oh,
there he goes.
Goodbye, Cowers. Still 4-on-4. And NQZ is able to strike for one onto Decenti. That nade opens the smoke up, perhaps gives away a bit of the info. No way! With that headshot, maybe that's something in there for Imperial. This is awkward, very awkward indeed, as NQZ misses that first shot, but makes amends for it, and it looks like it should be on lockdown still for PaiN. Scary for a second, but
done onto Phelps, minus 50. And eventually he drops to the hands of Cowes. You know what? You had asked earlier if they were thinking that was two rounds was enough when the half switched over. And if they weren't thinking two was enough when the half switched over, they're definitely thinking it now.
Yeah, most definitely. Because they're in a great spot to grab another one and doesn't quite cleanly hit the spray, but pretty straightforward to get that spam through. Scaffolding onto Vinny and ours will get the trade on to Try, so a couple of flashes over the top. It's not under too much pressure just yet, but that late flash comes into play. NQZ, though, will continue to keep the site in check for the moment. Bit of util out, but starting to get a bit concerned. The cross is there from Imperial. They've gotten close up behind Generator. NQZ hitting his shots for the moment, though, is keeping it okay. Try will go down. It's now the 1v2. Decenti has an AK in hand. How important that AK can be. We talked about it back end of that last round. And this could be the gun that gets him in with the clutch, or it could prove rather inconsequential because it was going to be always quite tough for him to get off different things, right? They're trying something a little bit different this time. We haven't really seen this from Imperial out towards the B bomb site, but again, it looks like PaiN is well prepared for it. The spam through the smoke, that battle though, will go the way of Imperial. NQZ though has been a bit of a rock and he'll lock things down. Aww. That's a nice shot onto Vinny. And it continues to slide further and further away from Imperial. And that slide is increasing in pace. And I wonder if it's unrecoverable at this point, unless maybe No Way can clutch something out. Not obviously missed there by Big Uzero. It was always going to be a bit of a tough one. And Kawes will lock it down. 11-10 for the make sure that they don't falter at the final hurdle. I don't get the sense that NQZ will. He is hitting just about everything at the moment. He's feeling confident as well. Wants to push his way forward. Snow will win a duel over towards the B bomb side. It's all a little bit messy though as some kills come through on both sides. Aww. Inside the smoke though, Snow has done enough to lock things down still. But he's got another test ahead as Imperial are going to come rampaging in his direction. Does not want to walk out of that smoke. It would be a mistake. Tags are in. Snow's making a bit of noise, but he's buying enough time as well. And No Way will fall.
It wasn't enough for them to win it as they heard the rotation. They might not expect the player in CT. He spotted them now. He has been spotted. Now they know. And look at this. PaiN is fully stacked over on the B site.
Oh, Lux is going to jump up though and give up his life. Cowers. Not going to be able to have an impact anymore. Imperial, they're going to pull a rabbit out the hat at the final moment where it was possible. Forward-looking smoke from PaiN that Imperial are going to have to...
Oh, oh my word.
That's one way to do
okay.
it.
Okay.
Good job to deny. So now they can swap positions. Yeah, Big Uzero is going to lock down here on the side. Oh, and that is outrageous. Big Uzero trying to get some information. Phelps is ready for it, and QZ gets the kill, and he's going to need to find more. Lux just has to lock down this smoke. That is his only job at this point in this round. Do not let anyone come through the smoke, and he's failed his job, unfortunately. And they try to deny the plant, but it's being planted in a safe position, and QZ gets one. They don't know for sure where Snow is. Now they do. Second kill for him. No, and it is denied. Imperial.
The only thing that Imperial can do at the moment is just keep trying to bash down that door and hope that they can get one. But that is supreme confidence from Kawes. He does not...
He's not going to be able to walk away from this. They're going to have eyes on it, and he's going to get taken down. Yeah, he needs to know that. That's a... But, oh, yeah, see, they've planned for this. Kawes is up top, and he's been spotted too. They don't... Ugh, it's just weird.
It's like they're not 100% comfortable with the angles.
Yeah, yeah.
Like, they know the concept or the idea, but... Where to actually put their feet 100% isn't maybe quite as locked in as it needs to be, but has it given a chance back into the round for Imperial? You'd think not. NQZ has, again, as I say, been so consistent with this AWP in hand. Okay, he's not really going to be able to do too much there. That's unfortunate, but has put it in a really good spot here for PaiN, and the Molly will tag Decenti down quite low. Because there are not going to be required in the end. It'll be Lux to finish it off, and that is 14 now for PaiN. So Snow's going to have to hit his shots here, and he's done so. Good start. Nice little headshot onto the second player there as well. Are they thinking about Lux maybe being around the corner too? Well, they were. It's a good enough trade to keep it at 3-on-3, but look at Kawes.
Oh.
He's got to be... You...
That's beautiful. Ooh. The trigger discipline. No chance for No Way. As Kawes takes him down, and right now that's a jump scare moment. I can tell you from firsthand experience, this game can be a horror game at times, and this is going to be the B split. It looks like the bomb is towards middle, so 3 mid, 1 B, 1 A, and that's the A player down. No Way gets a flash, gets the pick onto Big Uzero.
Big rotation coming into mid here from Try. He's going to be the difference maker potentially. The Molly, I mean, Kawes just goes in front of the Molly. Didn't give it time to bloom, and PaiN have let this round slip. Something chronic. Lux will do his best to salvage, but...
Here, there's a man at the sandbags who also has a smoke. Lux spots him, and Lux takes him down. Player at sandbags now, also getting hunted. Oh, he used his smoke outside of it! What did he do that for? Now he's gonna die. Lux is pushing forward. He's scaling through the site. There's one man here already. The AWP is still alive inside hall. Kalos and Lux get one apiece, and PaiN may have just done it. Try 1v4. They know that he was the guy who was boosting Phelps as well. So they know he's nearby. They know that he's somewhere in the area. They're just not quite sure where. And he is surrounded. They are closing in on him like sharks. He is the feed. And right now, he has no way of fighting back. There's too many teeth. And PaiN finally closed this one out.
E aí, gostou dos melhores momentos de hoje? Não se esquece, as estatísticas estão aqui para você analisar. Pausa o vídeo caso você queira ver e acompanhar tudo certinho. Sua inscrição e seu like aqui embaixo é muito importante para a evolução do canal. Te vejo no próximo vídeo. Fui!